You know, for those people that don't know, my wife is a fucking gook.
She's crazy. Right.
To me, she's the most beautiful gook in the world, but she's Japanese Filipino. The only 18-year-old virgin I ever heard of is Anthony.
Anthony who?
You!
Me? Are you kidding me?
You're still a virgin.
Virgin of what?
Virgin of sex.
Oh, I don't think so.
Having sex with farm animals doesn't count.
You know, I know this is going to sound disgusting, but I don't know what's worse. I mean, I mean, it's got to be on the same level. But I would rather live next door to a pedophile than live next door to him. Because at least I know a pedophile wouldn't be into me. You know what I mean? He's just a retard. Like, I'm afraid. Someone like that, and it's scary. He could vote. It's funny because he thinks we're poking jokes at him. We're not. He really is that retarded. It's
there is no way... that he is not either a full-fledged retard or has severe problems.
He's very close to it.
I guarantee you that he spends more time wiping drool from his mouth than he does blinking.
And, you know, he should learn. He should look like, go to websites that deal with retards. There's a reason why people are nice to you. People are, in society today, we are trained to be nice to the elderly, be nice to the dying, and be nice to the retard. When someone comes up to you and says, can you be my friend? Then I say, sure, you're my friend. Oh, are you really my friend? I don't give a shit about you.
Well, I'm sitting here in the car, and all of a sudden, I hear this knock on my window, right? And it's an Indian woman in her big dress with a big fucking dot on her head. And she says to me, what are you fuck here for? Why are you fuck here? What are you doing here? And I look at her and I'm like, oh my God, what the fuck are you doing here? She looked like Lily Munster except Hindu with a dot on her head. And I was going to start screaming at her, but I can see she's wearing one of those like Hindu wedding dresses. And I'm just like, oh, I'm just sitting here. I'm famous. I'm a famous wrestler. I don't care who you are.
She's crazy.
It's a wedding today.
Oh,
and so she walks away and they all just come out with candles. Right now, in front of my car while I'm doing this, I'm telling you, there's 400 Hindus with dots on their head and candles, and they're dancing around right in front of me. Indians are on this planet for two things. To smell like shit and to put out bad food.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Think of it. At my gym, they got this gook lady. She's like some 47-year-old gook, some flat-faced, flat-ass gook lady, training people, right? So, I mean, they shouldn't be fucking driving, let alone training people. So I go to the gym, and this 47-year-old flat-faced, flat-ass gook is training a man, right? If you were a man, would you want a woman training you, let alone a gook woman? I mean, do you know how that strips you of your dignity? Anthony, tell me if it doesn't. Anthony,
yeah.
We're not talking about a good-looking woman. We're talking about somebody that looks like she should be in 7-Eleven. How much would you pay for that?
Yeah,
would buy that?
I wouldn't want something like that training me, no.
But can I tell you something? I would rather get brutally raped by a big black guy than have somebody see some 47-year-old poop woman training me. You know that? At least if a black guy rapes you, you keep your mouth shut and don't tell anybody. Everybody sees you get humiliated by this stupid Chinese woman. I'm wrestling ringside, and I think I was wrestling like Ken Sweeney or something. And me and Ken, and we're doing our thing, and we're wrestling for like the 300th time. And there's this guy that works for us named Randy, and he would call himself Darkfire. And we had steel barricades like any professional wrestling federation should have.
Right.
And he, in the middle of my match, eating a hot dog, right? Within the barricade of the fucking match.
Right.
I flip. I hop. I was going to say I hop over the top rope. I couldn't hop over the top rope because it was I go onto the middle rope. I jump out of the ring. I flip. I just rip his pants off, right? And his pants, as soon as I whipped the belt off, the pants just fell around his ankle. I bent him over. I took the hot dog and I shove it in his ass. And when I shove it in his ass, I pull it out of his ass and stuff it in his mouth.
Let me tell you something. You know, I would go to massage parlors. I would spend like the $200 to get the massage, have the Japanese woman walk on your back for an hour and a half. And then she's like, you know, you give me $50. I'm telling you. It's true. One of those laughing boxes.
Did you understand that you're admitting to the mess, Maniac? That you went to a massage parlor to get a happy ending?
Yeah, the massage parlor was... But this is 15 years ago, Maniac. I mean, I'm still young, but...
You should have got a fucking hot money.
Frank, you got some racism in you, bro.
Oh, this time of
every time...
My wallet! Shut up! My wallet! My wife is a fucking girl! My wife is a gook! How can you get if I marry a gook?
Every time we talk, you always talk, and there's got to be something about some black, some race. It's got to be something. And Anthony, you need to watch who you hang out with, bro.
Don't you walk close? I don't hang out with him, bro.
I don't hang out with him.
We don't hang out together, bro. Yeah. All right, I'm not racist. I'm just, I'm very direct. Listen, Indians smell like shit. Chinks are bad drivers, and they smell like garlic. Jewish people are cheap bastards. I'm just, and they're not clean people. I'm just.
Like I said,
I'm honest.
You racist motherfucker. Because you know what you said? You said, I live in a black free community.
Black free neighborhood. Exactly. Black free neighborhood.
So you racist, Frank. You are a racist little motherfucker.
I'm not racist. I'm not little. I'm big and I got big muscles.